Today we'll discuss about the dissection part of the anterior abdominal wall. First we will see about the surface marking, important surface landmarks of the anterior abdominal wall. This part is the jubbatmosis, which corresponds here, which is the part of the sternum. Sternum has got three parts, mandibular sternum, body of the sternum and jubbatmosis. And this is the corresponding side of the jubbatmosis. And this is the symphysis pubis. This is symphysis pubis. And this is umbilicus. This is umbilicus. And here is the costal margin. Costal margin. And this is the costal margin. Here is the costal margin. And in the lateral aspect of the rectus muscle, there is the linea semilunaris. Linea semilunaris on the right side. On the right side, there is the angle, it corresponds with the teeth of the ninth costal cartilage, and which corresponds with the fundus of the gallbladder. Next, these are the important. For descriptive purposes, the anterior abdominal wall is divided into nine regions by two vertical lines and two horizontal lines. The vertical lines pass from the midpoint of the clavicle vertically up to the inguinal ligament, and it also passes through the mid inguinal point. So mid clavicular, mid inguinal, the same thing. So on the right side there is one, on the left side there is another. These are the vertical lines. There are two horizontal lines. One is transpyloric, another is transtubercular. Transpyloric plane is passed through the midway between the suprasternal nos and the symphysis pubis, which corresponds roughly between the jubbatmosis and the umbilicus. And it, in the posterior aspect, it passes through the lower border of the first lumbar vertebra. And this is the symphysis pubis. Symphysis pubis corresponds to the tip of the coccyx. The posterior corresponds to the tip of the coccyx. Now, the incision. How will give the incision of the to dissect the anterior abdominal wall? Dissection should start from the jubbat process up to the symphysis pubis encircling the umbilicus. This is the vertical incision. There is another transverse incision along the inguinal ligament, and it extends to the lateral. Inguinal ligament extends to the lateral. And there is another incision from the jubbat process laterally up to the mid axillary line. Now, next point is to replug the skin laterally. Skin plug laterally. So after reflecting the skin plug, we will see the superficial fascia. Superficial fascia in the abdomen, in the lower part of the abdomen especially, it divides into the two layers, that is the fascia of Scarpa and fascia of Campa. And deep fascia is absent in the abdomen, and next layer is the muscles of the abdomen. Muscles of the abdomen, there are three flat muscles in the abdomen. These are external oblique, internal oblique and transversus abdominis. These muscles are flat muscles. These are wide flat muscles of the abdomen, and this is vertically oriented, that is the rectus abdominis muscle. So the each of the three muscles, that is the external oblique, internal oblique and transversus abdominis, has got muscular part and affinity. Muscular part is muscle, consists of muscle tissue, and affinity part is the connective tissue. So each of the three has this arrangement. Now the arrangement of the external oblique, internal oblique and transversus abdominis. Origin. External oblique origin from the lower 8 ribs. From the external surface, the outer surface of the lower 8 ribs. And the muscle radiates from this downwards and medially. Downwards and medially from the lower 8 ribs. From the external surface, it goes downwards and medially. So insertion is from the jubbat process, linear elbow, inguinal ligament and the iliacus. So it has got the origin from the outer aspect of the ribs, lower rib ribs, and insertion, wide insertion, that is the external oblique muscle, origin and insertion. Now the internal oblique. Internal oblique has got the origin from the thoracolumbar fascia, which is situated in the back. That is the inguinal ligament and the external there is the leaf of the iliac crest, medial leaf of the iliac crest. These three are the origin of the internal oblique muscle. Next, the transversus abdominis. Insertion. Insertion of the internal oblique also almost same. There is the costal margin, then the linea alba and linea alba insertion. Transversus abdominis, it also originates from the thoracolumbar fossa and the iliac crest and the, that is the inguinal ligament. It also inserts into the linea alba. Now the nerve supply. Nerve supply of these muscles come from lower six thoracic and first lumbar. That is the iliohypogastric and ilioinguinal nerve. Lower six thoracic and first lumbar means iliohypogastric and ilioinguinal nerves. Now the rectus abdominis. Rectus abdominis muscle originates from the symphysis pubis, front of the symphysis pubis, and it inserts into the in front of the 5th, 6th, and 7th costal cartilages. And it is vertically oriented muscle. It is vertically oriented muscle, origin below and insertion is up. And its nerve supply is from the lower 6th thoracic nerves. Now the disposition of the rectus, action of the muscles of the abdominal wall are main four muscles, that is the movement of the trunk. As the rectus muscle is front, so if it contracts, it flexes the trunk. That is, it flexes the thoracic spine and lumbar spine. And in addition, the oblique muscles are rotator and lateral flexor of the trunk. In addition, as the muscles are attached to the iliac crest and the ribs, so